max stack versus low stack running shoes. I feel like this is something I spend a lot of time talking about on this channel, and it's going to be something I'm talking about more on this channel given how much max stack shoes we're seeing from manufacturers into 2024. It's going to get kind of crazy. But what are the differences between these, and why do you want one over the other? Well, it's much more than just cushioning, and in fact, cushioning may be kind of the thing that doesn't really matter. And the bottom line here is you probably want to be running in both. Before we can get into this, we need to define what max stack is and what low stack is. For max stack, I'm going to use the definition of any shoe that has more than 32 mil of foam in the forefoot, which, given where we've seen as a preview of what's coming out in 2024, we may need to increase that if I do this video a year from now. That's how high shoes are getting. A low stack shoe, on the other hand, I'm going to define in 2024 as any shoe with under 25 mil of foam in the forefoot. Now, that's actually kind of crazy because just a couple years ago, a low stack shoe would have been anything under 20 mil of foam in the forefoot. Honestly, probably a shoe closer to about 15 mil of foam in the forefoot. But those shoes just don't exist. For the most part, low stack shoes, sadly in 2024, have to be defined as 25 mil of foam and below. So if we go back to the max stack shoes, I think the Brooks Ghost Max is probably the best example of what you're going to get in a max stack shoe. Mainly, you can see there's a ton of foam in this shoe. And because of that, you need to have a very prominent forefoot rocker, a rocker under the toe. Because if you didn't have that and you had a more traditional geometry and you had much more foam under your foot, it would be much harder to toe off in this shoe because there'd be so much foam there. Mechanically, it would just be very difficult to get up over the toe in this shoe. So with a max stack shoe with all of this foam, you generally have to have this rocker to make it runnable. And if you look at the Asics Nova Blast 4, I think you can see it in even a more extreme way because you have a much more prominent forefoot rocker, but you also have a very prominent heel bevel. So this shoe not only has that prominent forefoot rocker, but it has a very prominent heel to toe rocker for heel strikers landing in the shoe, moving forward and toeing off. Again, if this shoe did not have this rocker and you had a ton of foam stack that continued to the toe, you mechanically just couldn't get up over the toe in this shoe. So that is something that you have to have in a max stack shoe. Going back to the low stack shoe, I think you can see that very traditional geometry. There is a little of a curl up in the toe of this shoe, but it's not, I wouldn't call it a rocker. It's more there because naturally this shoe sort of takes the shape of your foot and it curls up over time. If it didn't have that, it was dead flat, it would also be very awkward to run in the shoe. But there isn't a lot of rocker in this shoe. There's a little bit of a heel bevel here, but again, this is a very flat shoe compared to the max stack heavily rockered shoes. And looking at the Adidas SA, again, you can see that very clearly. There isn't much of a rocker in this forefoot. There's just a very flat, very minimal midsole stack with, you know, just a tiny bit of curve up in the toe. And frankly, this shoe is molded to my foot because I have quite a few miles in this shoe at this point. So it's actually sort of molded more to my foot, which makes it feel even better to run in. The on-foot feel and run differences between a max stack shoe and a low stack shoe are significant. In your max stack shoe, because you have all this foam and more because you have this rocker, this is going to be a shoe that's better for runners who maybe don't have feet that are quite as strong. Maybe they have some ankle immobility. Their lower legs in general maybe need a little bit more protection. This is going to be the kind of shoe that's going to be better for that sort of runner because, again, this foam is going to absorb a lot of that impact, and this rocker is going to help the shoe sort of move over the toe, which, again, if you don't have a lot of strength or mobility in your lower leg and foot, this is going to be what you want to overcome that. Conversely, in the lower stack shoe, because there is so much less foam here, therefore this shoe is going to be a little bit more flexible, in some cases quite a bit more flexible. This shoe is going to put a lot more emphasis on your foot and ankle to be strong. This is going to put a lot more emphasis on your mechanics, your foot strike, and it's not going to help aid you over the toe. This is going to really force you to work much harder, especially if you're used to only running in those higher stack rocker shoes. This shoe is going to feel like you're running in glue sometimes because it's just not helping you in the same way. The other key difference in a max stack shoe versus a low stack shoe is the amount of foam. Now, that seems obvious, but what you're sacrificing when you're running in this max stack shoe is stability. And it doesn't matter if it's firmer foam or very soft foam, you're still sacrificing stability. If you think about it, if you're running on this big platform of foam, even if it's a firmer foam, your foot is still further from the ground. You're still going to sacrifice a lot of stability. And designers and engineers of these shoes overcome that by making the outsoles or the engineering the width of the midsole foam to be extremely wide. Or in the case of the Nova Blast 4, you can see that they flare out the forefoot quite a bit. There's like terraces that come off the sides of this shoe, which give this some more stability. And in the heel, you have a lot of foam that wraps up around the foot, around the heel, to stabilize the heel during heel strike. Now, back to the low stack shoe, where you're sacrificing stability in the max stack shoe. In a low stack shoe, you're generally not sacrificing stability at all. In fact, these are very stable shoes. What you're gaining here, though, is a lot of ground feel. Now, that doesn't mean you have to feel every single pebble or crack in the road as you're running on. It's more about feeling connected to the surface that you're running on, giving you much more of a direct ride, which a lot of runners still like. I'm one of those runners who likes that. So, if your low stack shoe gives you a very direct, connected feel to the road, your max stack shoe, generally speaking, gives you a very smooth ride. A lot of people describe, especially in a softer foam shoe, that sort of sensation of rolling forward in this rockered high stack shoe as very smooth. Now, again, for a easy run, that's great. Some days you just want to go out and have the shoe kind of help you just kind of toe over and get those miles in or get those kilometers in. But you don't always want that. While a max stack shoe may be very smooth, if you're doing faster running, and I'm talking faster than 5K pace up to threshold pace, a lot of runners will complain that this big chunk of foam under the forefoot and this extreme rocker sort of get in your way when you're really trying to pick up the pace. It's almost like the cadence that this shoe wants to run in, that it wants to roll smoothly forward. If you're trying to run really fast, you're going faster than the cadence that this shoe's designed to do. So again, for faster running, a max stack, heavily rockered shoe may not be the best choice. Back to the lower stack shoe, this traditional geometry generally will let you be in charge of the shoe. So it doesn't matter the pace you're running at, you're always going to be able to control this shoe. You're going to feel very in control of this style of shoe. So if you're going easy, this shoe's not going to tick you over or roll you forward as smoothly, but you're still going to be fully capable of that. And if you're doing faster work, again, faster than 5K up to threshold pace, then this shoe's not going to get in the way because it's all about you. It's all about your form. It's all about feeling connected to the ground and having that very direct ride. That direct ride is really going to allow you to really be in control of the shoe and very much manipulate the shoe to go faster and faster. The bottom line here is it is about training stimulus. And this is also where it gets really murky because now we're getting into personal biomechanics and injury history. Generally speaking, and I'm oversimplifying quite a bit here, if you have a history of lower leg or foot issues, that max stack rocker shoe is generally going to feel pretty good because mechanically it's going to help aid you rolling over that, and it's going to save your lower leg. But running is a high impact activity, and no matter what shoe you're running in, you can't escape the forces. So the problem that comes with the max stack shoes is even though they're saving your foot, your ankle, your calves, your lower leg, they're shifting the forces up to the knee and the hips. So if you have chronic knee or hip issues, maybe those max stack shoes aren't always going to be the best thing to be running in. Conversely, that lower stack shoe is going to put a lot more emphasis on strong feet, strong ankles, good calves, really allowing all of the foot and the calf to work as the shock absorber that it really is meant to be. But again, if you have a history of injuries in that area, that's probably going to be very difficult for you. But I'm going to say, and this is why ultimately I say you need to be running in both these shoes. If you're just running in one or the other all of the time, you're missing some of that training stimulus because you're only giving your body one type of stimulus all the time. So if you're mixing it up, going between the max stack rocker shoe and the low stack traditional geometry shoe, you're now giving a range of stimulus to the body. And in training, we're training most of the time that we're running, you're building up different conditioning in the body, which ultimately is what we want to be doing in training. Thank you for making it to the end of the video. If you like this type of content, consider subscribing. You'll see more content from me pop up in your feed. If not, drop a like on this video because it helps this channel continue to grow, which I always appreciate. And with that, I'll catch you in the next one.